Hello again. In this video, we'll talk about variables. Now, what are variables? Just imagine variables as a container. Because in programming, when you talk about software, now software is all about data. So when you build a software, you're actually processing lots of data, right? Because what is IT? IT is all about information, right? So you build a software just to store that data. And where to store that data? So we have variables. Now, why this call is variable? It's because you can change your data. So when you are allowed to change anything, it is called as variable, right? So imagine this container as a variable. Now, this container can have different values, right? So example, if you have, let's say I want to have headphones, okay? So let's say this headphone, you want to save it somewhere. So we have multiple options. So you can have a headphone cover, you can use mobile cover, or you can use laptop cover. So you can use any of this cover, right? So we can open a laptop cover, we can put headphones. We can open a mobile cover, we can put headphones. We can use a headphone cover to put headphones. Now let's say, so that covers, those are variables, and your headphone is the value. Now let's say we have a mobile phone. So to keep a mobile phone, we have again three options. We have headphone cover, we have mobile cover, we have laptop cover. So we can keep a mobile phone inside a mobile cover, we can keep it inside a laptop cover. I don't prefer to put a mobile phone inside a headphone cover. Is it possible? Yeah, if it is a Nokia 1100 phone, we can try, but I cannot put an iPhone inside a headphone cover. That's not possible, right? So yeah, so for different type of values, we have different variables. Or different type of variables. So in programming terms, if you want to store a number, so for number we have this, which is int. Okay, now why it is int? Because it is integer, so you can have a value from negative range to positive range, maybe negative range to positive range. Then we have a different type of data, which is called as float. So let's say if you want to assign a point value, so let's say 5.5, 7.6. So those are your point values. So to store those point values, we require this type of variable, which is this type of data, which is float. Let's say you want to store a character, maybe 5, or no, not 5, maybe A, B, N. So to store those characters, we require char. So basically we have int, we have float, we have char, we have one more which is called a double. Now double has more size than float, okay? And in Java, by default, all values, maybe 7.5, 7.6, all point values, they are double by default. Okay, then we have long. So we have lots of data types, right? So this int, float, those are data types which define the type of the variable. So when I say int I, so I is the variable and int is the data type. Simple. And so when I say int I equal to 5, so that 5 is the value. I is the variable and int is the data type. So we can store, so if we talk about the size, so int takes 2 bytes, int takes 4 bytes, in C it takes 2 bytes. So int takes 2 bytes, float takes 4 bytes, char takes 2 bytes in Java. So this, we have different size for this, so you can see your table there. So we have for int, we have 4 bytes, for float we have 4 bytes, so we have a list of that list there. So for different values, we have different data type, right? So now let's say you have a value inside int, so which is 5. So let's say int I equal to 5. Now you can assign the same value to float variable. That's possible because the size of float also is 4. We can assign the same value to double value. But can we assign a double value to int? It's like putting your laptop inside a mobile cover. So what you have to do is we have to cut your laptop in the size of mobile phone, and then you can put your laptop inside a mobile cover. That's what happens here. So when I say we have a variable, which is, we have a value which is 5.5, and you want to store this 5.5, which is a double value, inside a int, you will lose some data. You will lose 0.5. You will only store 5. Simple. So this, all data types are called as primitive data type. So we have something more. Yes, we also have reference variables. Again, what is reference variable? That we'll discuss when we start with objects. Okay. So that is from variable. So thanks for watching and do subscribe for further videos.